time for Three and Out, once again being brought to you by the Shin Splints Recovery Group. If you have any nagging or ailments in your lower leg area, the Shin Splints Recovery Group, it's a group for you. You can find them on Facebook, where Victoria is a member, where she says, I do a lot of power walking at the park, and now I'm suffering from shin splints. Ouch. This is very painful. So if you have any advice for Victoria with your shin splints, go to the Shin Splints Recovery Group on Facebook. All right, your first Three and Out question tonight. We will start with you, Alan. Would you rather be a bowling champion or a curling champion?
I think it's curling.
Ooh, okay. Why?
Right off the bat. I don't know. That just seems a lot. It just seems like a lot more fun. There's a lot more moving parts. I get to take a break. Like, I've always wondered what do. Not that I don't get to take a break in bowling either, but like, I'm always kind of locked in. You know what I mean? I'm like, shit. All right, fucking. You know, cut a little hard on the eight last time. I want to clean that up next round. You know, I'm analyzing. When the other sweeper guys and or tosser guy. Technical terms, get up to do their thing, there's two fucking dudes just hanging out doing nothing. So I don't know what they're analyzing. I'm sure there's probably something to analyze, but I mean, it's just sliding a rock on ice, so how complicated could it get? So yeah, curling for me. I think it's good, like a lot of fucking street cred these days after the last Olympics, so I think Next time comes around you could be on a fucking like Nike deal. You know, or a Wheaties box. You don't know. Push it hard. Olympians get fucking endorsed come Olympic time for the stupidest shit. And it's just because they're about to compete. Who gives a shit that the jiu-jitsu person's fucking sponsored by Crystal Light? Nobody cares, but still, sponsorship money. So, curling all the way.
Get the new Nike Ice Slider now with dual Velcro.
Yeah. Yeah, because all the single Velcro step used to come off, caused a catastrophe in Helsinki. Can't have that happening.
Bloodbath.
Yeah.
Wes, where do you go? Are you a bowling champion or are you a curling champion, and why?
I see where Alan's coming from, but he's talking about a once in every 4 year thing, a phenomenon that comes about where now that people who don't work get to watch the Olympics during the middle of the day and understand, like, right, left, yeah, yeah, go, keep going, yeah, yeah, all right. This like modified, glorified sweeping of ice that can maneuver some sort of 8 kilo ball into one direction or another. I'm not putting my stake as an athlete, former athlete, fucking current athlete, into anybody else. Fuck that. It's me and the lane and the pins. And the goddamn, you know, 8, 9, 12 pound ball that I have in my hand and the curl that I'm going to put on that fucker. I'm going to be a professional bowler. All right. Walter Ray Williams Sr., goddamn Kingpin, Farley Brothers, one of the greatest movies of all time. Hell yeah. Bowling, baby. Bowling.
Yeah. I was torn when I thought about this because.
When's the last curling movie you ever fucking seen?
Well, I guarantee it's coming, and it's going to star fucking Will Ferrell. You know it is. It's right either around the corner.
Either that or Seth Rogen and
that's
James
true.
Franco.
Oh, man. You know what? There's your trio right there. That's a curling team if I ever saw
that's
one.
A fucking curling team right there. See? Yeah.
I can see where Alan's coming from. I mean, if it's a group effort, I feel like you could definitely drink some beers while you curl. Like, you don't got to keep it. Like, how straight you got to keep it, man? Yeah. Played my best shuffleboard when I was like 6 beers deep at the rendezvous. Like, and that's all it is.
I expect that at every fucking curling arena, which is just a hockey rink repurposed, has a fucking open bar. Like, that would make fucking sense to me. Like, those two guys are kicking it with the fucking Canadians having a Labette while fucking Jim, John, and Frank get fucking points on the board because they had a fucking rough round last time and they need to pick it up. This is bullshit.
However, I do agree with Wes that I want the glory for myself, and bowling is a more skillful sport. And if you're going to be good at something, be good at something that requires greatness to be good at. But curling has gained so much in popularity over the last like 12 years that, I mean, I can't name any bowlers. I can name Pete Weber. That's it. Hmm. Done. End of story. And so if being a great bowler is worth being a great bowler, then I feel like it should pay off more. There should be you should be rewarded with hefty contracts. Your name should be plastered all over ESPN. But that doesn't happen. So why would I work so hard to be so famous at a sport that nobody cares about? Why not be not famous at a sport that nobody cares about, but still reaps about the same amount of glory, and I can drink on ice with my friends while doing something that's requires very little skill at all?
Also, the opportunity to go to the Olympics.
That's true, too. There is no bowling in the Olympics. Yeah. So, okay, if you go to a party and you say, yeah, I'm an Olympic champion. Like, I mean, you could stop the conversation there, walk away, and everybody thinks you're some sort of mysterious badass. You don't have to tell them what you're an Olympic champion in. There's no Olympic champion bowlers.
But have you seen, like, the American curling team? The physique is roughly what's happening here on this fucking Zoom call. So it's not like anybody's being like, damn, I mean, he does look like a fucking elite athlete. they'd be like, what the fuck did he medal in? That's ridiculous.
So I think just for the opportunity to win an Olympic medal, I'm going to choose curling over bowling, even though I do respect bowling more as an athletic achievement. Curling gives me a higher reward.
And you say that soon in the next 5 years, there's going to be a curling movie?
I think, yes. I think in the next 5 years, now that we've mentioned it, there's going to be a curling movie starring Will Ferrell, Seth Rogen, and James Franco.
All right.
With Dave Franco as their coach.
Yes. Nah, it's got to be an old guy. But Dave Franco is probably like an alternate or something. Or he's got to come save the day when like somebody twists an ankle or something.
Maybe Will Ferrell's the coach because Will Ferrell's getting kind of old.
Or, yeah, Will Ferrell will be the coach. And like James Franco, because it's definitely going to have weed in it because Seth Rogen and shit. So like one of them is going to get popped for a drug test right before they take on the fucking Swedes, who I'm assuming are number one in the world at the time. And then Dave Franco comes in and fills the role because he's been training with them all his life, but he just wasn't good enough to make the team.
Do you think they really drug test for curlers in the Olympics? Like, is there any really
enhancement? For weed, maybe?
USADA. If you get into to Olympics, it's all USADA. Yeah. But I would say I think Jonah Hill would play the antagonist. Ooh. For like the German team. He'd be like, oh, sissy boys.
I think it just needs to be everyone from the German side of Beer Fest.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So it's got to be like Will Forte. Like, yeah. Just rack them all up. Same German team.
Everyone from Dancing for the Stars.
I just feel like the imagery of Jonah Hill rubbing his nipples and mocking someone got him the role immediately.